Hi, everybody. Paul is here. We can start. Nancy's here. Hi, everybody.
Hi.
It's that time of year. We're in the culmination of the holiday season, the big finale. Right? Everybody ready? Cool. Well, it's nice to see everybody's faces. We've got a couple new people. This is nice. Nice crowd today. Hi, everybody. I hope you're having a good week and a good little holiday season. I hear most of the, I live on the West Coast, but I hear most of the East Coast is snowed in right now. So.
Not New York anymore.
Really?
Thank God. That was
okay. Good. All right. Well, welcome to Welcome Diner, Open Diner. This is our, 35th episode now, our 35th meeting. And today our topic is Lonely No More. And we're going to talk about the reason and the solution for loneliness that many feel nowadays, even when there's so many people so living so closely together, there's still even more and more people experiencing loneliness. This is a cameras on event, so if you can turn on your cameras, that would be wonderful. It helps us to connect to each other, and it helps us to, it gives you the opportunity to really benefit from this event. Some of the activities we will be doing involve being able to see each other. And if you're joining us on Facebook or YouTube, and Facebook is going right now, I hear, hello and welcome to Open Diner. And in the chat, be sure to let us know your name, where you're from, and participate in the questions, and we'll try to read them during the event tonight. First, we're going to watch a brief presentation about the Zoom functions and the general format of this event. So everybody pay attention carefully.
When you start Zoom, your microphone is muted by default. Before you can speak, you must unmute yourself. The mute/unmute button on the computer is at the lower left. On the iPad, it's the first item on top. Remember to mute yourself when you are done speaking. During the event, there might be a need to read from the chat. Roundtable questions will be displayed there. Sometimes answers from other participants are summarized for a later discussion. You can also use the chat to make comments, get technical advice, etc. The chat button on a computer is here in the middle. On the iPad, it is in the three-dot menu here.
All right, we got that right. Well, let's test out how well we can do on muting and unmuting ourselves. We're gonna just go around and introduce ourselves and tell us where you're from, and then after you introduce yourself, pick somebody else. Look on the screen, pick somebody else, and ask them to introduce themselves. So I'm Gary, I'm your main host tonight. I live in Pasadena, California. And let's see, Paula, tell us where you're from.
Hi, Gary. Hi, I'm Paula, I'm from Brooklyn, New York. It's great to be here. If Rosanna could introduce herself, please.
Hi, my name is Rosanna, and I'm from Long Island, New York. If Betsy could introduce herself.
Hi, I'm Betsy from Long Island, New York. So nice to meet you all. Alyssa?
Hi, I'm Alyssa. I'm from New York, Brooklyn, and so good to see you all. It's amazing. Michael, would you please introduce yourself?
Hi, I'm Michael. I'm in Monroe, North Carolina. Let's see. Paula, could you go next?
Michael, I went already. Maybe somebody else could go.
Okay. Let's see. Natalia?
Hi, I'm Natalia from Chicago. And I would like, I don't know what else I need to say about myself, but there is also Shirley. Shirley, right? Can you introduce yourself?
Yeah, Shirley, there you go.
Shirley?
Yeah.
Hi.
That would be you. Hi.
I'm from Philadelphia. And I thought I'd stop in and say hello.
All right. We'll pick somebody else so they can introduce themselves. Okay. How about Chad? Oh, you already introduced yourself, didn't you?
I did not.
Okay.
I'm Chad. I'm from Northeast Ohio. Nice to meet everyone. Let's see. Eva, how about you introduce yourself next?
Hi, thank you, Chad. I'm Eva. I'm from New York, Brooklyn. And if I can pronounce your name correctly, it's
Itch.
Itch, right. I'm so sorry. Itch.
No problem.
What a beautiful name. Just the first time I see such name. It's beautiful.
My name is Edge, and I also am from Philadelphia. I can't see the large screen, so I don't know how to ask for somebody else to speak. So if you would ask somebody for me.
Brandon. Nice to see you back again.
Thank you for having me back. I'm Brandon. I'm from the Bronx, New York. And Elena.
Thank you, Brendan. My name is Ilana. I am from Brooklyn, New York. And who didn't go yet? Let's see. Betsy went. Nancy.
You're muted. You can do it. I know you can.
I just said, Eiga Vault. I'm Nancy, and I love this group. And I'm born in the city, raised in Connecticut, and lots of stuff after. But let's see, who should introduce themselves? Am I allowed to ask Anthony to, or is he technically not part of the group?
Oh, he's very much part of the group.
Well, excuse me, Mr. Cohn, would you please, excuse me, this is serious here, sir. Could you please introduce yourself, dear?
Hello, everybody. My name is Anthony Cohen. And I am French, but I live in New York City as well. And this is not a window. I will pass it on to, have you spoken, Dan, yet?
Not yet. I'm Dan, I'm from Ontario, Canada. And it's really not that cold yet. How about Ben?
I'm Ben from Southwest Colorado. Lyle, are you able to speak?
Gary, do something.
I'll try. Who else hasn't? Linda, have you been introduced yet? Oh, Betsy. Linda?
Yeah, I'm Linda, and I live in upstate New York, though I was born and raised in Manhattan. And let's see, who else is here? Lyle?
Betsy, have you introduced yourself?
I have. I think Roberta, I choose you.
Okay. I think we've gone around everybody, right? I think
got me, Gary.
Oh, Roberta. Oh, yeah.
I was waiting at me. I'm like, who didn't speak?
I didn't forget about you, Roberta.
Thank you. I'm Roberta from Long Island, New York, and I think we didn't hear from our lawyer friend, Alice, back. I saw his hand up. I don't know if I know he has the screen off, but maybe he can't speak. He usually can't, but I think we've reached everybody except Lyahu and Al, but back to you, Gary.
And all me. Right.
Oh, and me.
Nina.
I'm Nina from Brooklyn, New York. I'm back to New York. I was in Boston last week. Good to be here. Thank you.
All right. Thanks, everybody. Nice to see everybody. And we're going to start off here with our first song by Anthony. His second appearance here. Everybody loves Anthony, and he's going to give us some beautiful music here. Thanks.
Thank you so much. I'm going to sing a song by Elton John. Since we are talking about loneliness, it's a song called Rocket Man. It's a man, an astronaut, who lives partly on planet Earth and partly in space and planet Mars. So he gets very lonely and he thinks about his family. And I'm going to change the background since we're going to travel from New York City into planet Mars out of space for the song Rocket Man by Elton John. She packed my bag last night, pre-flight 09 a.m. Gonna be high as a kite by then. I miss the earth so much. I miss my wife. It's lonely out in space. Such a time, let's fly. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time till touchdown brings me round again to find I'm not a man, I think I am at home. Oh no, I'm the rocket man. Rocket man, burning and his fuse up here alone. Mars ain't the kind of place to raise your kids. In fact, it's cold as hell. You did. And all the science I don't understand. It's my job 5 days a week. Rocket man, rocket man. Touchdown brings me round again to find another man. I think I am at home. Oh no, I'm the rocket man. Rocket man, burning out his fuse up here alone. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time till touchdown brings me round again to find another man, I think I am at home. Oh no, I'm the rocket man. here alone. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time. It's gonna be a long, long time. Thank you.
Thanks, Anthony. Wonderful. And I just wanted to let everybody know Anthony has a Christmas special coming up on Saturday. I'll do a link for it in the chat in a little bit at the end of the open diner today. All right. So we're going to move along here. I just wanted to go over that, talk just a little bit about what we're doing. Open Diner is a place where that was created at the beginning of the coronavirus as a place of support where people could connect, have a positive atmosphere, warm atmosphere, feel welcomed, feel like, you know, they're connected. They have somebody they can connect to in a safe, nice atmosphere. And what we do here is we connect above our differences. We stay on topic when during the questions. No criticism, no controversial, especially no politics. That's a little touchy. So just create a warm atmosphere of acceptance for everybody. And just a reminder to mute your microphone when you're not speaking, and if you can turn on your cameras, that really helps a lot too. It helps us to connect connect with each other. Then when we go into questions and answers, just remember to keep your answers brief. So we have a lot of people here today, so keep your answers brief so everybody can have a chance to talk. And so anyway, we're going to move along. We're going to have a little icebreaker here, and Linda's going to break the ice for us. Get out your ice pick.
Thank you, Gary. Okay, we're going to play a little game here, and we've played it before, so some of you might know how to play it. It's get to know each other, and it's called the I Am game. One person starts by saying, I am, say, a student. And then if anybody else is a student, they jump in and say, I am a student and I am also a movie buff. So whoever's a movie buff goes next. And if nobody can identify with it, pick another thing about yourself. So I'll start. And I'm Linda and I'm also a nurse.
Well, I'm Alyssa, and I really don't like to be in touch with nurses and doctors and anyone like that. But I am a nature lover, and I love especially oceans and sea and some, you know, water, big pools of water.
Definitely a nature lover. I love hiking and nature photography. And I'm also a writer.
I'm also like hiking and actually climbing the mountains. So, and I'm a photographer as well.
Well, I'm a writer, but I was too late. But I also love to swim.
I love to swim too. I like swimming in the public pools. And I also write poetry and short stories, and I repossess cars for a living.
Okay, I can relate to Brandon. I'm in the automotive business, actually. And I do like the water. And I wish I was in Florida right now on a vacation. Nobody wants to be on vacation, really?
Well, yes, yeah,
that's exactly.
Here we go. Thank you. Go ahead.
Actually, Florida vacation, that's really speaks to me. And I am also, I'm also likes to play music. I was a musician at the time.
I play piano and I enjoy, you know, I can solve the Rubik's Cube.
Oh.
Good luck with that one.
Okay, I love salted caramel ice cream.
I love ice cream and I'm a Capricorn.
I'm a Capricorn and I like kayaking.
I love kayaking also, and I also love to play volleyball.
I used to love to play volleyball. I went already, but I had to jump in on that one. I also love ice skating. Anyone?
Okay, I can't ice skate.
Nobody likes ice skating.
Go ahead, Linda, go ahead.
I was just going to say, nobody likes ice skating. Nobody goes to Rockefeller Center and ice skates there.
I can only go once, though. That's the deal.
We are all from Florida.
Yes.
Don't go to Florida. The Republican governor doesn't want anybody to wear masks. No.
No politics.
No politics.
Oh, well, sorry. All right.
Okay, let's move to ping pong. Who likes to play ping pong? I am really a fan.
Well, Lisa, I wish we could play ping pong sometime soon because I like ping pong, but also I love music and opera.
I like music. I am a musician also. I don't have my keyboard here in front of me like Anthony does, but I was also going to say that I'm also a pyrotechnician, but I don't think I'd get very many responses on that. Let's see. I'm a Taurus.
I also like to blow things up in a controlled, wet fashion. And I'm a gardener. I like to garden.
I like to garden also. And what else? I speak another language. Portuguese, by the way.
Now I know some of you speak other languages. Come on.
We can jump so many times, you know. Yeah, I do speak Russian. And that is great to hit. to know more than one language. I wish I knew more, including Portuguese.
Yeah,
I tried to learn Portuguese. It's very difficult.
Yeah, I agree. And I also am an aspiring language learner. I haven't progressed very far from English, I suppose. I would love to learn German and Greek and Latin and Hebrew. And a little bit about me. I love swimming in pools that are non-chlorinated, and I love the Kingdom of Heaven.
I thought everybody will open their mics. I think that we're all lovers of Kingdom of Heaven.
Who hasn't gone? Let's see. Denise, have you gone? You got to unmute. You're muted. Can't hear you.
Hello. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Hi. I just came on for the first time. And I'm only seeing one person at a time. So I don't know, I'm on my phone. I don't know if there's a better way for this. I guess I could get to my computer, but hello.
Hi, there's there's a way you can do gallery view on your phone.
How do I do that on my phone? I see participants, share screen, stop video, mute, but I don't see gallery on my phone.
It's under view.
Let me see.
On my phone, I just scroll a little bit. And it'll
scroll from right to the left. Just scroll from right to the left.
Oh, there I get a few more people.
There you go.
Okay, now I see four at a time.
Well, what do you like to do, Denise?
Oh, I like to do a lot of things. I'm a writer. I write. I like to take classes. I'm a meditator. I like to hike and walk. I try to walk even in the cold. I have a nice jacket and I go out for a walk, try to do it every day unless it's raining or snowing. Love nature. I heard people talking about another language, so I speak a little Hebrew. And what else? I'm a crafter. I like crafts, do a lot of artsy things. And I like to travel when it's not COVID. I feel like I'm imprisoned right now. I'm a free spirit and you can't be free right now. Well, within a certain box. So that's a little bit about me.
Anyone else like to travel? Let's see who hasn't gone yet. Ruben or Al?
Oh, did you hear me?
We have a lot more people joining. It's filling up.
Hey. Hi, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Yeah, so what is the real question? What is the question that you're asking?
Well, what do you like to do?
Oh, my hobbies. Okay, so I do like to travel. I do like to learn, and I'm also exploring new hobbies. So there's no one set thing I like to do all the time.
Thank you, Ruben. I think we've run out of time for this section, and I'll hand it over to Gary.
Hi, thanks. It's nice getting to know everybody. This is a nice crowd today. We're going to move on. We're kind of running a little bit behind here, but we're going to watch a video now. And this is the based on the topic of our of Lonely No More. So let's watch this video.
Human desires are the driving force behind everything we go through as individuals and as a species. Our desires are constantly evolving beneath the surface, shaping human experience. From bodily animalistic desires like food, sex, and shelter, to human social desires such as money, honor, power, and knowledge. At every stage of development, these dominant desires organize our lives and form our societies. In the 20th century, our desires drove us to seek a comfortable and prosperous material life. We set our sights on things like developing a career, building a family, buying a house, having some savings, traveling the world, and acquiring material possessions. Human beings saw these as sources of joy and pleasure in their pursuit of happiness. But recently, the evolution of human desire entered a new level, and people began to demand a different kind of fulfillment, finding the meaning of life itself and our purpose as human beings. But as that desire for life's meaning and purpose awakens in masses of people, it ushers in the next phase of human evolution. What they now feel is simply a devastating sense of emptiness that grays out everything else, a void that sucks everything else into it. All the pleasures they are familiar with lose their appeal and no longer inspire hope for happiness. Communities are falling apart, And as people shift to the space of virtual communications, they mistakenly suppose that from now on they can manage without a real caring environment. As a result, a person looks for the solution to all the problems one-on-one with himself, inside his shell perched by a computer screen. People twitter short trills, hoping to express something that won't be heard by anyone a moment later. Anything requiring inner efforts, persistence, and time is rejected at the root. When a person is empty, having no true goal, then worry and depression settle in. So where can he get that goal? Where can he find meaning? Today, all serious researchers assert that happiness lies inside contact with others, in giving to others, and that real meaning can only be revealed in the interconnection between us. This newly developing and unfamiliar desire directs us to find connection with the source of life, and the way to establish contact with it is through a deeper level of connection between us. In other words, human connection is the key, or the entrance to a new dimension of human experience, where we feel connected to each other through the natural life source that connects and binds all of nature. We become a catalyst for change because this is nature's way of pushing us towards connection. Eventually, we begin to sense our innate connection as a human species and find resonance with a deeper force of connection in nature, and the connection with that natural binding force gives us the sense of meaning and purpose in life. Every human is a social creature, nourished and shaped by connection with others. Through a deeper connection between us, we find contact with our life's source, and that gives us the sense of meaning, purpose, and happiness we crave. It's that simple. It's the realization of the plan of creation.
Okay. All right, everybody. So now we're going to hit the main course, which we're going to move on to a roundtable discussion. But before that, we're going to watch a short clip of some Zoom functions that we're going to be using now. So we'll watch that. One sec.
The mute-unmute button on a computer is at the lower left. On the iPad, it's the first item on top. The chat button on a computer is here in the middle. On the iPad, it is in the three-dot menu here.
Okay, great. We'll need those functions in a second, you'll see. So we're going to go over some etiquette rules, or really etiquette tools, about working in a roundtable discussion with the next two questions we're going to have. So I'm going to watch a screen here, and we'll just discuss it a little bit. Roundtable etiquette. We're here to build space of support, love, care, and warmth. Like I said, these are more tools, more than rules. So if everyone is equal and very important here. A lot of times when we have a lot of people here tonight, so a lot of times if you're waiting to say the next thing, before the other person is speaking, you're already thinking, what am I gonna say? But if you really listen to the other person, you'll start getting the answer yourself of what you could possibly say and actually build on that. We're gonna go around the table and speak briefly and on topic. Like I said, again, a lot of people here, so let's try to keep it short and on topic and listen intently, of course. And there's no right or wrong answers. This is just speaking from your heart and what you're thinking and what the last person said, and we're gonna build on that. So the truth is in the center of our connection, and you're going to see that will be true after everybody speaks, and it'll build a bigger picture. So it's a great thing to do and listen and participate in. So I'm going to give you the first question now, and since there's so many people, I'm going to call names on friends that are here. So the first question, which will be in the chat, is, as the number of people on Earth continues to grow, why do you think there are more lonely people than non-lonely people, technically? They usually say more the merrier. So you would think the more people that are out there, people would be happy, they wouldn't be lonely. So why do you think that is? Why are more people lonely when there's more people on this earth? And the first person I'll pick, Betsy, would you like to add to that? Or?
It's funny because the first thing I thought about is 24-hour news and how it scares people and they
might feel like they want to hibernate away from, you know, be away from socializing because they're very afraid. Should I pick somebody else?
No, I'll pick. This is okay. So many people. We won't want that lapse. How about Chad? Where's Chad? Did he leave? Okay, we'll come back to Chad if he connects again. How about Nancy? Nancy Bronstein. You're muted.
The reason why we're all lonely now is because everything can be done via computer. And that's why they said there is such an increasing amount of lonely people. It's been spoken about on the Hidden Brain. I mean, it's all over the place. It's because you don't have to connect. Let's just you and I go on FaceTime. It's crap. And as long as everybody's on the computer, you lose connection. It's what's so difficult for all of us now.
Mm-hmm.
Everything's virtual, and so
you miss the human touch. True, very true. How about Paula? Would you like to add?
Yeah, I think. Right now people are isolated, so it's definitely increasing everyone's loneliness. Even though there are more people, nobody can interact with each other, so everyone's isolated.
True, Rosanna.
I just feel like the older we get, it's harder to make friends and keep them because everybody has like their own set of friends already. So I find that true for myself. Like most of the people that I have in my life are like acquaintances. They're not like real friends.
Hmm. Yep. How about Edge? We lost Edge. Okay. Baba Ben.
Can you turn your microphone on? We cannot hear you.
Oh, there she is. She's down on the bottom. There's so many people. There's two screens. I'm so sorry. Inge. There you go. You got it. Now I see it. Thanks, Eva. Yes.
I think the fact that we can't actually touch somebody, we can't give somebody a hug, we can't shake hands with somebody, all these things come to us, and they really make us feel very isolated.
Very true. Ben? No, how about Michael B? Here you are. Baker.
I think, well, I don't really know. My reasoning is different probably than most because I only feel comfort from certain types of people. So I am lonely a lot because those types of people reject me if I ask them. So I don't know. For people in general, I don't think that rule applies. So I don't know.
Well, you're here. And you've spoken very nice what you added. How about Shirley? Do you like to add to what Michael said?
Right. I think all the answers were great. And one of the big ones is the diversity of the country. You talked about so many people that we have now. And we have a long way to go to be able to accept this diversity. And I think that's part of being lonely. There's so many differences of us.
Thank you, Shirley. So, did you want to add something else?
No.
Okay, I didn't want to cut you off, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
How about Brandon?
Being single, it's hard to make the connection with the pretty people who are unapproachable.
Okay. I don't know if Lyle could speak before we called him, and I know he has a picture up, but Lyle, can you speak or no? Maybe not still. How about Mary Lou? No, OK. Okay.
There's a lot of lonely people now because most people are stuck at home, and it's hard, like someone else said, to establish relationships, new friendships. So people just stay at home and isolate, like I do, and get depressed, basically. Thank you for asking.
Thank you for sharing. Arthur, would you like to add?
Yeah. So I agree with most of the opinions of the people, but I read in Adam Smith's seminal work that he observed back in like the 17th century that overcrowding, overpopulation, urban life leads to anonymity, isolation, loneliness, and other psychological issues. And you can notice that today with like rural life versus urban life or overcrowded settings.
Okay, thank you. I don't think we heard from Pamela.
Hi, I think I'm in agreement with the whole pandemic and people kind of being on their own and not being able to see and touch and feel their families and whatnot, and just feeling so distanced from everyone that it really, if you weren't lonely before and you're, you know, experiencing it for the first time, I'm sure it's overwhelming to many people.
Mm-hmm. True. I think we're going to go to the next question. We have another question to answer. And let me read it to you, it'll be in the chat also. It says, imagine you have a close person who is lonely. What is your recommendation or advice to him or her to come out of this state? What would you recommend to them? So I'll call on next Dan. What would you recommend?
I've already recommended Open Diner.
Good recommendation. how about Rosanna?
I'm having a hard time with battling loneliness, so I don't really have any good advice. I'm sorry.
That's okay. We'll listen and we'll learn. And we'll figure it out ourselves, you know, together. How about Ruben? Can you help us out here?
Hold on a second.
Sure.
The question is how you, Go ahead.
No, I'll read it again. It says, imagine you have a close person who is lonely. What is the recommendation or advice you'd give to him or her to come out of this state of loneliness? What can you recommend to somebody that is going through something like this?
Well, I would try to develop a support system where you talk about something that has happened to you that leads you to that mental condition of feeling that you're lonely all the time, and just having somebody you can talk to on a regular basis, even if it's for like a short time, to kind of get you out of that that feeling. Because sometimes your feelings can also be your perception of your own self, how you view the world around you. So for me now, I try to do a lot of social activities because, you know, that's a natural thing that you're going to always feel lonely. I don't think that has to do with anything in particular. I just feel like, you know, if you're very antisocial and you're not really allowing yourself to express that in to somebody else or in an activity, then you'll always continually experience that feeling of loneliness.
Nice.
So,
no, it's good. Thank you so much.
Because I, for myself, I know what that is, but there's different levels of loneliness, different levels of feeling like, oh, how am I lonely? And I'm in a group of, I'm in a room of people who I know or I don't know, and I still feel lonely. So I think that's something else going on with the person themselves. So
Maybe. Maybe.
I don't know. I don't think there's one answer to that, but
no, definitely not.
I don't think there's one answer to how do you handle that and resolve that completely. I think it all depends on the person too.
Thank you, Ruben. Thank you very much for sharing.
Yes. You're welcome.
How about Denise?
Unmute. Okay.
There you go.
All right. Well, I join a number of different Zooms to help me. I'm more on a spiritual path, so I find some different meetings that I go to like these and get to converse with people. That's one way that I stay with people and not lonely. And also, even when it's cold, because I'm in Jersey, it's I walk in the park. And sometimes I'll invite a friend so we can social distance walk. And I find also like communing with nature and the animals. I usually take seeds and nuts and feed the ducks and the birds. So I don't know, I feel like the animals are also my friends. So they keep me from being lonely. And I know like there's a big thing now, a lot of people are getting puppies and cats and, you know, hopefully they'll keep them after the pandemic, but it's helping them from really being lonely, people that I've talked to. So maybe, you know, I have suggested that to other friends of mine that they, you know, if they feel like they can get a puppy or an older dog to keep them company. And, you know, some actually two of them are going to do that because they feel like that'll help them.
I'm sure it will. So, I have a dog myself, and without my dog, it would have been difficult through the pandemic for sure. Thank you for sharing that. How about Betsy? Would you like to add?
I think finding something to volunteer, whether it's with animals or just getting out of yourself and jumping in and doing something to volunteer and help somebody else get out of your own head.
Very good. We have time for one more. How about Alana? Would you like to add to that?
Yeah, I actually want to add actually to what Betsy said. I really think that a great idea is to volunteer, is to try to get out, whatever makes you get out of yourself and try to care for someone else. That's a really good way to get out of loneliness, because then you connect to someone else or to many others really by caring.
Thank you, Alana. Well, this was a very deep topic and I think we all felt it, but we're going to do something very light right now. It's the dessert we call of the open diner. We're going to do a dance and we're going to move our hands, and this screen is going to come up, and there's usually writing when it comes to it. It's called a screen shot or a screen sharing. When it comes up, you're going to see a writing that actually means you're on the screen. So we're going to hear music. And when the screen comes up with that writing, you're going to do a dance move, whatever it is. And we're all of us here are going to replicate you, and we're going to do that dance move. And it's going to go to each person. We're going to spotlight each person. So let's have some fun. Let's relax. Like I said, this was a heavy topic, but let's shake it all out and do some dancing. So let's enjoy ourselves. And when the...
We want to know.
And we all come to be.
We want you to know that you make your heart sing. You do. And we need you to know we sing this song to bring joy to you. We are living in a world.
All right, everybody loosened up? That was fun. Let's see, what do we got going on now? What we're gonna do is a little wrap up. We're getting close to the end of our little, of our meeting here. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go around and give each other compliments. We're gonna do a little compliment game. I'm going to compliment someone, and what you're going to do is pick somebody else who might have impressed you or said something that, you know, you really liked, or you just maybe like their shoes or something, or just their smile. And you can say anything that you want, or, you know, or they have nice, bright, shiny teeth. Who cares? But I am going to compliment Arthur because I love what he said about how the bigger that a city gets, the more alienated people get. And that's why I'm moving out of LA and I'm gonna be moving to Greenville, South Carolina soon to get into a smaller area. So I really appreciated the what he said about that. So Arthur, your turn to compliment someone.
Thank you, Mr. Higgins. That's very kind of you. I hope we can have the British model of living where people have like an urban penthouse and a pad in the city, as well as a country home. So we can have both the best of both worlds. You know, I love both the city and the countryside. And onto the compliments, I would say, you know, I love the golden plaque in Miss Bronstein's background and the bookshelf in her background. I can't really tell. I apologize. I don't know what to compliment, but I just thought I will say that the decor looks nice, looks minimalist, and looks like the color. I like the color scheme. It's light and golden, and which is. Something that appeals to me. Thank you.
You're muted, Nancy. You're muted.
I know. I didn't know if that was my turn.
Yeah, it's your turn.
It's the side of Emily Dickinson's, all of Emily Dickinson's poems. That's what that is. But I would like to compliment Michael, because Michael, you're here. You got a little cutie dog or something. And I want to compliment you for saying, you know what, I'm going to join. And I want you to know that this has helped me so much. So I just want, sometimes I've been so depressed. You just wait. You just found a group of people who like you already, and you can't beat it. So take care of yourself and remember that.
Well, I think Michael has disappeared.
I also wanted to compliment Michael, but he left. So yeah. I hope he hears everything that we are sending his way, you know, all the good waves. So I really want to compliment Rosanna. Thank you so much. You were so open in everything that you said. And it's really, today's was an absolutely incredible conversation because we open our hearts to each other. And your heart definitely touched mine. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Eva. I appreciate that. I want to compliment Ruben because I really liked what she said, and it really made me think like a lot. So thank you, Ruben.
Ruben, you wanna? Are you there still?
Come on, we got a lot of compliments here. Let's go.
I know.
Well, Gary, I'll give you a compliment because I think the idea that you're moving to a smaller place is right on target. That's what I'm thinking too. It's you got to go smaller.
Yeah.
I agree 1,000%.
Okay, well, then I'll give a compliment to Betsy. Thanks for coming back. And it's a pleasure. Your energy is just wonderful. I love what you bring to the table.
Thank you. And I'd like to compliment Roberta, who I think the same thing. I think that she was one of the first ones that I met here. And she has a beautiful smile and she's just very comforting and wonderful.
Yeah. Thank you, Betty. Can I give one more compliment? I'd like to say it to Shirley. You're so lovely. You spoke from your heart and it was so nice seeing, I think you were here once or twice before and it was very nice to see you again. You know, it's nice to, when people come and they speak, it's a very nice thing. And thank you.
Thank you very much. I think I'd like to say thank you to Anthony tonight because I'm a music lover and he brought the music tonight. And especially the keyboard because I've decided to learn to play the piano. I'm on page 2. I know nothing about music, but I've been on page 2 for over a week. So watch out, Anthony. I may have your spot.
I know it was
and I don't the last...
Sorry, please.
I recommend ahead. Anthony.
Thank you so much, Ali. I really appreciate it. I know we don't have much time. I just want to say a quick shout out to Al, who's been putting all this nice little... applaud, the little thumb sign. You're not. We cannot see you, but we can feel you. Thank you for all your support. I can see you're present with us.
I don't know if Al can talk, but we're going to have to wrap up this segment. I'd like to thank everybody here and compliment everyone. Denise for being here. Pamela, especially. She's been just a breath of fresh air all the time. All of you are wonderful and we couldn't do this without you. So what we're going to do now is we're going to have one more song by Anthony. And like I said, he has a Christmas special coming up the day after Christmas and I'm posting a link in the chat for it. So it's going to be at noon on Eastern time on Saturday. And everybody, it's Chanson de Noël, right? Yes.
Absolutely, okay. Yes.
Yeah, so tell us, just mention a little bit about it and then do your song.
Well, you know what? Better than this, I'm going to show you a preview live with one of the songs that I will be singing on Saturday. And for this, let me put a nice Christmas background. How is this one? Okay, welcome to Christmas time. And maybe why not having a little Christmas hat.
Oh, Anthony.
I can hear you, Nancy. There you go. Okay, excellent. Excellent. So get ready. This is Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas to get into the Christmas mode. Thank you all for everything. Thank you to the Open Diner team. And this is for everybody to have a great Christmas. Thank you.
myself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. Next year all our troubles will be out of sight.
Thank you, Anthony. And I posted the link for his special, which is in a couple days. And be sure to go watch him, visit him, support him. He's wonderful. So we're going to wrap it up.
Can I ask Anthony a question?
I'm sure you can.
Anthony, okay, that I love that song, Rocket Man, but there's one song, one line I never understood, and it's like, hurling around the streets of heaven on, or something like this, and I know you sang it, but I didn't hear it. So tell me, wait, what is it? Is it here, hurling around space alone?
Blowing out his fuse up here alone.
There you go.
Blowing out his fuse up here alone. Blowing out his fuse up here alone. Yes. No, well, thanks, Anthony. Now I know what the heck I'm singing. That's a compliment.
Actually, it's Rocket Man burning out his fuse up here alone.
So I'm say it again.
Burning out his fuse up here alone.
Burning out up here, his fuse alone.
I don't know, something like this. It's just poetic, I guess.
Yeah.
We all learned something new today.
Burning. Now I'm going to go turn it on and sing.
Okay. But after we're done.
No. Thanks, Gary.
All right. We had a good time. I thank everybody for being here. It's just wonderful. I love meeting all the new people. And I hope you come back, and I hope you felt welcome and warm and invited, because that's how we want to make you feel, that everybody here, somebody was talking about diversity today, and that's what we celebrate here, is diversity. We celebrate everybody's uniqueness, and we look for it. So follow us. We're on Facebook. We're on Meetup, YouTube, Twitter, Instagram. Can you put up that slide, please? And everybody can see where we follow us, like us. There's all of our events. There's the recordings of all of our events are on YouTube that you can go to. In the chat, too, all the links are there. So you can watch all of our events, and it's really, you know, fun to see yourself, you know. And let's see. So for the next couple weeks, here they come. Facebook, Facebook, Meetup, YouTube, Instagram, Twitter. So follow us, like us. Tell your friends, bring back some friends. We love meeting everybody. And so for the next couple weeks, next week, again, we'll be on Wednesday instead of Thursday because of New Year's Eve. We don't want to interfere with that. So I know everybody's going to be going out and doing all kinds of stuff, right, on New Year's Eve. Yeah. All right. Hope you come back next week, 6:30 on Wednesday. And it was great having you all here. Thank you so much.
I just want to add something, Gary. Like you said, next Wednesday, because of New Year's, and then after that New Year's, we're going to do our regular Thursdays back to 6:30. So just next week, and then we're back to our Thursday. So I just wanted to reiterate that so we don't lose anybody to our Thursday nights again. Thanks again, friends.
Yeah. Thank you all. And we'll see you next week.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Happy holidays.
Happy holidays.
Holidays.
Merry Christmas.